Hello, Crush Riverians. The best school has come to stay in the city of Calabar. It is called Beryl International School.
Take advantage of this opportunity. Now.
Tell me the best school. Beryl is the best. Tell me the best school.
Hello, everybody in grade 4 and grade 5. How are you doing today? Nice to be back. Remember last week that we were concentrating, we were doing this topic. And this topic is going to take us for a while. It's going to take us for a while, maybe 2 weeks. So we started looking at the formats of letter. And now by formats of letter, we simply mean how we can structure our letter writing. How we can structure. Alright, so we were saying how we can format our letters. So, like I told you last week, we basically have three types of letters, but at the senior level, as you grow, you are going to see that it's two. So I told you last week that we have informal letters, and then we have formal letters, and then we have this one, semi-formal. Now you remember what we said about these types of letters. This is the type of letter we write to somebody that is bigger than us in terms of rank and in terms of status. When you write to somebody who is bigger than you in terms of age and in terms of position, you are writing semi-formal letters. And then I remember I told you that when you are writing this type of letter, politeness and respect should be there. There should be politeness and respect because you are writing to somebody who is bigger than you in age and bigger than you in status, like in position. So that is semi-formal letter. Now this one is official or business letters. Now it is the type of letter we write to somebody we don't really know, somebody that is not close to us, and now we write it either for business or for official reasons. So that is why it is known as official or business letters. So when you write, for instance, application letters, when you write to for correspondence between two offices, these are all under formal letters. Now the next one is this one. That is the one you are very, very conversant with. I'm sure you must have done it before. This one, that is informal letters, or you call it personal letter or love letters. Now when I say love letters, I'm not talking about immoral love, okay? We're talking about personal letters. Personal letters. So when you write to somebody that's very close to you, okay, somebody that's very close to you, somebody that you know very well, very close. For instance, when you write to your mom, to your dad, to your brother, to your sister, to friends, classmates, you name your uncles and aunties. So these are all love letters or informal letters. Alright, having said that, we now come to this format which we started last week. So, the semi-formal letters, when we want to structure formats or when we want to write letters, is going to obviously fall under informal letters. So, I'm going to divide them into two now. Formal letters and then informal letters. Okay? Now, the formal letters are generally structured into seven parts. Why this one will be formatted into five parts whenever you're writing this? Now, let us get the seven parts first. The first thing you do is address of the writer. We discussed this last week. Address of the writer. The writer of the letter. that is they are forcing you to when you want to write all the same thing here. Address of the writer. Address of the writer. Now the second thing is the date. Date of writing the letter. The same thing here. Date of writing the letter. Now, this one, other formal letter, this is one, this is two. The next thing is receiver's address or recipient address. Recipient address. Now, this recipient address is the address of the office you are sending the letter to. For instance, you are writing an application letter and you are asked to maybe a condo bank. Now, after the date, you come to the left-hand side, like we discussed last time, that's where you write the recipient address or the receiver's address. The office where the letter is going, you put it at the left-hand side. Now, when you come here, after this, you go to salutation. Salutation. You remember what we said last week? Salutation simply is the identification of the person you are writing to. So that is one, that is two, that is three. Now, after this one, we'll come to the salutation. After the receiver's address, we'll come to the salutation. Please, note what we are doing, because this is how you're going to be writing it. You're going to be writing your formal letter, you're going to be writing your informal letter. So, you go to the salutation. Now, here, after this one, the next thing is the body of the letter. Body of the letter. Body of the letter. Now you come back here. After salutation, the next thing you're going to have is heading. Heading. Heading, or you can call it title. Title of the letter. Title of the letter. Now, because the former letter will have a title, and that is what is the subject matter of the letter. Okay? So, if it is application, when the receiver picks the letter, now he will not say, okay, this is for application. Somebody wants to wants to work here. Now they will file it in where applications should be. So obviously this is very, very important. Now this one, the next one, is the body itself. The body of the letter. The body of the letter. Why here? Number five will be conclusion. Conclusion of the letter. Now here seven, number seven here will be conclusion of the letter. Have you seen it there? So this is how you're going to be writing. In exam situation, in a real life situation, this is how you're going to be writing. This one, five parts, whether it's formal or semi-formal, five parts. This one, seven parts. This is how you're going to structure your writing. Oh, okay. Now, last week I stopped at address or something like that. I stopped at address, so we're not going to visit address again. Then let me quickly remind you what we said that day. We talked about the two types of address. We talked about the punctuation of address. We talked about organization of your address. I hope you all remember this. So if you forgot, please refer to your book where we copied it that day. So we talked about the two types. We have two types. We have block and indented type of address. And then we'll look at the punctuation, which is very, very important. The punctuation of address, of your address, which is very, very important at the end of every line. Now, the next thing we talked about is your use of capital letters. Okay, so I told you that all the initial alphabets in address will start with capital letters. All the initial alphabets We'll start with capital letters. So I told him of this. Now, for instance, if you are writing Cross River, you don't have to write it like this. This is wrong. This is wrong. Okay? Because you are talking about the compound noun. Okay? So we delete this one and make it capital S. We delete this one and make it capital R. And then this one too, we delete it and make it like that. Have you seen it now? Because we are talking about compound noun, Cross River State refers to one entity, and that's the state. So when you want to write Nigeria, you don't dare write like this. If the letter is going overseas, you don't dare do something like this. No. The examiner will mark you down. You will be penalized seriously. Because this is a noun, so you write it like this. We're not going to go into that. I know we stopped somewhere around it. So maybe that's where I will start today. Alright, having said all this, I'm going to delete everything here. So today, which is a formatting of letters. So we're going to start with the date. Alright, so we're going to the second part. Second part of a letter. Let's say we're picking informal letter now. Informal letters. We're going to the second part, which is address. So we write the the date. The date is refers to three things: the day of writing, the month of writing, and the year of writing. Now today is 16th June. 2020. Now you see how it is on the board. That's how you're going to be writing your own. Don't think that you can escape any of this. You see these punctuation marks here. They are very, very important. It doesn't cost you anything to do it. And you see this TH, that's how it should be. Don't put your TH up like we discussed last week. Don't put your TH up. Put them in the same line. And make sure that the month will start with capital letters. And then at the end of the year, you drop your full stop. Okay. So this one is straightforward. It gives us true information, like I said. The day of writing is, and the month of writing, and the year of writing. Beautiful. Now, let's quickly go to the next one, which is what? Salutation. The next one, salutation. Number three, salutation. Salutation. What is salutation? We doubled into it last week, and I told you that salutation is not greeting. Salutation in letter writing simply refers to the identification of the owner of the letter. Identification of the person we're writing to. Okay? Identification of the person we are writing to. That is what salutation is. Now, so what does this mean? It simply means you have to identify the person by his or her first name. Remember? Now, there will be something that will be in your mind as I said this. If I'm writing to my mom, if I'm writing to my dad, if I'm writing to that big uncle, should I mention their name? No. How do you refer to your dad at home? How do you call him at home? You say that, yeah, you write dear dad there. Or you say mommy, you write mommy there. Or you say mama, if you be calling your mom mama too, you write mama there. Alright, so that is it. You don't, if your dad is Richard, you don't say dear Richard when you write. No, because that's not what you call him at home. You say that. You refer to him. So you don't, in writing to him, you don't say dear Richard. It looks insulting. Disrespectful, insolent. So you write dear dad. Now let's assume we are writing to a friend in another school. So how do you identify? You simply use the person's first name. Dear Michael. Then you punctuate. Now, another thing in salutation, like we said last week, it brings the intimacy of the person you are writing to. It brings the relationship of the person you are writing to into focus. Now, if I'm not too close to you, I will not, or if I'm close to you, I'm going to employ a kind of salutation that befits my closeness to you.
Okay.
So we have other forms of salutation apart from this. We can say, my dear Michael, my dear Michael, my dearest Michael. You see now this one is far deeper than this other one. My dearest Michael. Michael. My dearest Michael, and so on. My darling Michael. My darling Michael. Alright, so these are some of the...
We have so many of them.
We have so many of them. If the person is very far, is not too close, just an acquaintance, you can say hello. Hello, Mike. Or hello, Michael. So these are some of the ways you can salute, some of the ways you can identify the person you're writing to. Well, of course, it depends on the degree of intimacy. Now, let's go deeper now. Well, that's number three. So number four is the body of the letter. So we're going to number four now, the body of the letter. And that's where we're going to dwell so much. Number four, the body of the letter. All right. Now, the body of the letter is that part. This is the part that contains the reason or reasons of writing the letter. So that's basically what the body is. The body is that part of the letter that takes care of the reason why you are writing the letter. That's what the body is. So now, in this place, you have to be careful, structure your writing into paragraphs. That is the honesty in the body. You have to structure your writing into paragraphs. Make sure that your writing is structured into paragraphs. And make sure, well, I will not bother you so much in that case, because I know you are still coming up. But if it's this our block here in the secondary school block, I will insist that your writing should be in a manner that it should hit a crescendo. A crescendo simply means a high point. Now, for instance, if you're writing to you, let's say your dad is in Abuja, you are here in Cross River State Schooling, and you're writing to your dad to send you some money. You are not going to start a letter, "Dad, I need money, I need 10,000 naira," you know. No. After the preambles, the height, the main point of that letter is, "I need money." Then you can state it there. So everything will now fall in place, okay? You will now write it in a manner that it will hit the crescendo, the climax. You don't start, "I need money, I need 10,000 naira, I need 20,000 naira, I need 50,000." No. You write in a manner that after the normal, "How are you doing, Dad? I hope you're doing well. How is work there? How is the weather there?" Stuff like that. Over here in Calabar, we are doing well. My school is, you know, moving back. All right, so we're looking at the way we can structure our letters, our paragraphs, because that's the honesty in there. Body of the letter. You have to structure your... Okay. So we have to structure our writing in a manner that it will hit that climax. It will make the letter progressive. It will make the letter, everything flows naturally. One paragraph leading to another paragraph, and from that to another, until the letter comes out. So, number one thing we have to note in this part, this paragraph in... Paragraphing, okay? You have to paragraph your work. Now, let's say you in a letter, you are writing 7 paragraphs. It means that the first paragraph will be introduction and the last paragraph will be conclusion. Okay. Now we have 2 types of conclusion. Okay, let me reserve that one together. Now, another thing you note about this place is that your sentences matters. It matters so much. Understand that if you want your message to be understood by the person you're writing to, your sentences have to be very, very good. That is why I advise people, if there's no point making use of long, long sentences at this level, try to write short, short sentences that you can manage very well. You can manage them. Now, when you write long, long sentences, you'll be fumbling, punctuating them, trying to punctuate them to make them correct. Okay, so short, short sentences. Short, short sentences. And here too, your spelling, your ability to spell, will be tested here. So, you have to spell word correctly. I've seen a lot of you write something like this. No, this is wrong. Writing is just one T. Okay. So we're talking about the third criteria is your ability to spell words correctly. And I've just given you an instance here. This is wrong. So when you're writing, your ability to spell word will tell the person who will deliver the message what you want to say very well. For instance, this one is spelled this way, so I wouldn't want to see you write this again. Okay? I wouldn't want to see you write this again like this. So, spelling matters a lot. Now, when you're able to spell, and you're able to form your sentences very well, and you're able to do your paragraphing very well, you'll be writing a very, very good letter. What is this paragraphing? Paragraph is simply a body of writing with a main idea. A body of writing with a main idea. In other words, every paragraph, if you're having, like I said, 7 paragraphs to write, it means that you're going to be telling your dad in Abuja 7 things. And these things, we call them points. Points. So every of this paragraph will carry a point, what that paragraph is. Are you all with me? So that is how to write. Now let's quickly go to the conclusion. The conclusion. We're done with the body. Let's go to the conclusion. Now the conclusion is the ending part of the letter, or the when you are signing off the letter. Just like we have in salutation, the conclusion too, you know, has very, we have various conclusions too, depending on how close you are to this person you're writing to. So we have some conclusions like this one, yours affectionate. Some people say yours affectionately, still okay. Okay? Now you punctuate. Then you put your name. Let's say your name is Richard. You put your name, Richard. Now you put a full stop. Please, for heaven's sake, you don't put your surname there in informal letter. You don't put your surname. You don't put signature there. Now, as you're going to move to formal letter, that's where you will not sign. You don't put your surname. You don't put your signature there. Okay? So, that is it. Now, if you don't like this one, you can say love from. Love from. If you don't like this person, just affectionate. You can say love from Richard or Janet. Richard. To put a full stop there. So we have so many other ways. Alright. We have so many other ways. Oh, okay. So that is how to format informal letters. How to format informal letters. Next we want to will now basically format formal letters. This one we have finished with informal letters. So I want to believe that in exam situation or in real life situation, you should be able, from what you've learned in this e-learning, from what you've learned from this lesson, you should be able to write. Now, of course, I'm going to give you an assignment. I'm going to ask you to write to your friend. Let me write in an assignment. To your friend in another school. In another school, telling him or her how you are enjoying the COVID holiday, COVID-19 holiday. Oh, this platform, isn't it? All right, so that is it. Now, I expect to have this assignment next week. So, write a letter to your friend in another school, telling him or her how you are enjoying the COVID-19 holiday. Of course, I don't know how you can join it there, but I know that Agnes welcome. So that is it. When you set out to write informal letters, structure your letter into how many parts? Into 5 parts. And what is the 5 parts? The number one is address. And when we say address, we are referring to the writer. That is you writing the letter, your address. Then number two is the date. Like this one you are going to write, I will need to see all those. The date. The date that refers to the day you're writing, the month you're writing, and the year you're writing. Then the next one is salutation. Salutation there refers to the identification of the person you're writing to. And then the body of the letter, where you now state the reason. Now in this case, the reason is of writing is telling your friend how you're doing, how you enjoyed the holiday. So the last one is conclusion. And we have so many conclusions here, so many. You have yours affectionate, you have love from Richard, you have so many of them, yours truly. Alright, so having said that, we've come to the end of our lesson. God bless you and stay safe.